Now we come on to building confidence and destroying fear. So about fear, we must identify that it is real and it does exist to be able to treat it. About confidence, it's always acquired. Nobody is born with it. Another thing about fear is that action cures it. So there was a manager of one of the product categories in a retail company, and he was having a sense that he's losing grip somehow in the organization. So the sales were not happening in his department, although the sales were flourishing. I mean, the other departments were flourishing, and a lot of sales were happening in other departments. So he had started to feel afraid, not good about his company and about his position. He could sense that other people are talking about him, be it his subordinates or bosses or counterparts, everybody. And he had just given up all hopes. He was advised to do a few things and act upon it. He could strategize. Number one, he could strategize and identify what would work for him. For example, maybe a rearrangement of the products on the shelf, or maybe introducing a sale so that the current existing products would move and he could introduce some new products. Also, maybe that his team is not enthusiastic enough, which is not encouraging sales. So maybe motivating them. What else? Maybe also while you're working on this, maybe talking to your manager and talking to him about you've already identified the problem and you're working on the solution. All of this. And a second thing which will work as an insurance is like, be open to good opportunities, float your CV and tell other people, tell everybody else that you know that you're looking for an opportunity. And that is how, after this idea, he worked on it, he did all those things, found what was wrong, worked on it, used to hold huddles with his sales team to make them enthusiastic and motivate them, and also spoke to his manager. Because you see, for a manager, for a boss, for an employer, it's always expensive to hire a new person. So unless he knows that you're working on the problem to find a solution, he will not do that. He will definitely give you time and chance. This is what happened, and ultimately he was successful. The next time the author met him, he was already happy in his job. He also had a couple of offers, but he rejected them because he was very happy in this job. So this is what happens when you work on your fear. Your fear is destroyed. Some of people also have fear of people. Now, this was also illustrated by a beautiful example of a person who was somehow involved in army induction. This person was, you know, generally a very shy person, and he used to have a little fear of being in front of people and talking to them and being involved with them. So, but he witnessed this induction and it changed his life. How? He saw that there were a lot of people, all kinds of people during this induction from various backgrounds, be it farming, be it sales, be it blue collar jobs, business backgrounds, and different kinds of backgrounds. Even physically, some of them were fat, thin, short, tall, dark skinned, light skinned, all sorts of people. But he also realized that all of them liked good food, all of them were missing their family, all of them wanted to move ahead in life, all of them wanted to relax. So if basically at the base, if all the people are alike, then what is the use of being afraid of them? What is the use of having that fear from them? How about thinking big? Let's listen to a story about a blind milkman. So there was a milkman who came up to a family and asked them if they had any requirement for milk. But they denied and said that they were already taking it and from somewhere and were quite happy about it. But they also asked him to check the next door, to which he said that yes, he already did, but the demand was not so much and not worthwhile that I would stop there, because it was just 2 quarters per 2 days, which was too less for him to stop there and, you know, give milk to them. To which the family told him and asked him if he was blind. Did he not see a new addition to the family coming up very soon? Because the lady was pregnant, and of course with the child, the demand would rise. He went and took up their order. And in a few months only, the demand had already gone up to more than double, to 7 quarters per 2 days. Now imagine, had the milkman continued to be blind, he would have lost such a big opportunity. He would have lost it. Big thinkers are specialists in creating positive, forward-looking thoughts in their own mind and also in the minds of others. So, for example, instead of saying, "I'm sorry to report we have failed," he would say, "Here's a new approach I think will work." Instead of saying that we have incurred a big expense, he would rather say, "We have made a big investment." Instead of saying we face a problem, he says, "We face a challenge that we have to overcome." Basically, thinking big is all about seeing not just what is, but what can be.